Alright guys, what is up? Welcome to First Look at Escape from Tarkov. For those of you who don't know, Escape of Tarkov is, I think, just another one of those survival games that came out of the DayZ craze. DayZ is really the game that helped me build my channel, but once I realized that I hated DayZ, I stopped playing it and I went back to Arma. The main reason I hate DayZ is because it's... What I wanted out of it was a cooperative experience where I could go through, a survival wasteland type thing with my friends. But what it ended up being was just a garbage fest of shoot-on-site PvP. For like the first 2 weeks, it was really awesome. Players worked together and they helped each other out. And then after that first 2 weeks, it just turned into the DayZ everyone knows, which is pretty much garbage. So Escape from Tarkov, the way it's different from DayZ is no zombies. It is made by some of the guys that made Stalker, though, so there might be zombies in the future. But it's got, I guess, three factions. It's got two player factions and one NPC faction. And the NPCs are the guys that you fight against. So what I'm going to do in this video today is I'm going to show you a little bit of what's on the screen you see now, the character and the trading stuff. And then I'm going to play a single player level that I've already played through and gotten through, and then I'll go into the multiplayer area and probably get shot and rage quit almost immediately. So first thing I did was I checked my character, or made my I don't remember, I guess I don't have to make it again, but this is what my character looks like. This is what my character looks like. There we go. This ridiculous Russian badass. So I read when you get to make your character, it gives you the two factions. One is like Bear, which is the native Russian faction, and one is like the US faction, which is like a bunch of asshole mercenaries. So I chose the Russian faction. And one of the first things I did was look at my gear. Now, I guess I was given a press account. When I was given the game, I was given the game by the guys who make Escape from Tarkov. Actually, when I first heard about Escape from Tarkov, I emailed them and I was like, "Hey, I'd love to test out this game for you guys." And then last month, they finally emailed me back. Like literally, I think it was like a year and a week later. They're like, "Yeah, you still want to do that?" I was like, "Yeah, sure." So you start out with a bunch of stuff in your inventory. My first couple of playthroughs, I went through with nothing. And I just picked stuff up as I went. But then finally I put on the body armor and I grabbed the AK and the pistol. So I guess what I'll do in this playthrough is I'll unequip all the stuff that I have equipped. Oh, can you actually run out? Oh, I didn't realize you could actually run out of space in the inventory. Fold the stock. I don't know. So I'll go in with just a pistol and a couple of pistol magazines and my cool ass sunglasses. And of course, a tomahawk, tactical tomahawk. So one of the big things about this game that they've advertised and everyone was real excited about is the super realistic gun customization. So I'll show you guys that before I head out for the first time. And I had a gun here that I was playing around with. So I found this AK almost completely dismantled. So I'll take the extra stuff off of it and then we'll go from zero. So I found this, which is an AK upper, or I guess an AK. There's no upper and lower on an AK like there is on an AR. But so I found this thing in one of my first playthroughs while I was playtesting it, and it's got pretty much nothing on it. Now, technically, I could add a magazine to this, if you know anything about AKs, and it would fire, because it's got all of the functional parts. It's got the bolt, it's got the receiver, it's got the trigger... stuff that goes on the inside. So in real life, at this point, this thing would fire. Obviously not ideal. But I'll mess around with it. I've got some parts. I don't think I have enough parts to put it fully together. So I have pistol grip, and I have... Oh, I've got a suppressor. I'll just throw that on there for fun. And then I've got... Let's see. Handguards for the front. And that's all I've got for this thing right now. I tried to find a stock in the store that would go on there, but I didn't have the money for the one type of stock. So, I bought an upper receiver cover. Where is it? In the magazine. Okay, it's right here. Dust cover for an AK-74. This is an AK-74. Let's take a look at it. AK-74N. So it won't, maybe it won't go on the AKS-74U. Alright. So what I'll do is I'll go over to this other AK-74 and check out what it's got on it. So it's got everything it's got. Well, here, we'll strip it down, put it back together. And when you put parts on a weapon, well, let's get it stripped down first, and I'll go over those. Okay, so this is it completely stripped down. Now, if I put a part on, so it's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 attachment points. If I put something that has more attachment points on it, like I think this, these handguards, it's got a rail system. So the handguards itself has extra attachment points. So those pop up. So now instead of 7, it's got 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the handguards have 3 attachment points, and it's already got a flashlight on it. So see the flashlight on that attachment point, and then the other two are empty. And then for the muzzle, we'll put on a muzzle brake, or is that a muzzle brake, or is, what does it say? Can I inspect it from here? Nope. All right. And I'll put a vertical grip on the bottom. And I guess we have no bolt. It's got a bolt in it, but I guess maybe there are upgrades for the bolts you can get. Receiver, we'll put the dust cover with the iron sights on there. Stock, that stock, this pistol grip. And then 30-round magazine. What spot is that? I don't know what that is on the receiver, what goes there. I don't have anything to fill it. And depending on the magazine you have in the weapon, the magazine appearance does change. So if you're using a black mag, it's black. If you're using a tan mag, it's tan. 60-round mag, it's a 60-round mag. So that's pretty cool. I'll put a black mag in there, and then I'll go back to that other AK. Oops. Modding. I'll take all this stuff off of it. So now that one's empty. Go back to this one and replace that pistol grip with the black pistol grip. There we go. So that's pretty cool. That's the gun I was running around with. But like I said, I'm just going to run through this first level with the pistol. And see what I can pick up and scavenge. So... why is all this stuff in my inventory? Let's dump that. I don't know why it went into my inventory. I guess that's because I was messing around with it. Gun. What is that? Those are AK parts, so we'll put them down here with the AK. Yeah, so I've got a pistol with a flashlight, 2 spare mags, a hand grenade, and a tomahawk. And can I put this... Do they have an auto sort for the inventory? Okay, yes. I guess that's for radioactive stuff? Secure? I don't know. So, after you do every run, so say, comparing this to DayZ again, when you die in DayZ, you lose everything that you had on you. When you die in this game, first of all, if no one loots you, you don't lose any of your stuff. And second of all, you can put everything you loot in your stash, and you never lose the stuff in your stash. So that's one initial big difference between the two games. So let's go. And trading is real standard. There's a few vendors. I actually unlocked one of these vendors by getting close to them or something. I don't really know. But you can buy and sell and trade. Actually, you can only buy and sell. You can't trade. I haven't figured out a trade. I think there's a way to do that. But let's get into game. So, Scav. I think Scav is the NPC faction, so I don't know what joining that faction does for you, but you can't do that yet. So, this is my main character. It's the Russian bear guy. And it actually shows what your character currently has equipped on this screen. So, you see, all I've got is my sunglasses and my pistol. It's all I really need. And that actually happens to be a P226R. Which also happens to be what I've got right here. So I'm very familiar with this. Okay, now this is where you get to choose where you're gonna go. So the first game I ever played was single player, and I started at customs. I didn't see any NPCs or AI anywhere. But the factory, it's not necessarily open world. So in the factory, you start in the factory and you have to escape the factory. And once you escape from the factory, that run is considered over and you go back to the start screen. It's not you go into the factory and you scavenge and then you leave the factory and go to customs. I don't know if you can get from the outside world into the factory. I'm not sure how that works, but I'm gonna do a run through in the factory. And difficulty level is locked to insane. It estimates that getting through the factory will take about 40 minutes. And it recommends 4 to 6 players. So I'm gonna do offline for this. Enable PvE. I don't know what it does if I don't have PvE enabled. Does that mean the AI won't be there? I don't know. So I guess it's sort of like DayZ. You could find an empty server and go loot a bunch of stuff and then disconnect and connect to another server. So this game, it just lets you go offline. And yeah, that's it. And I don't remember how long the loading times were. I've only played this once before. So everything in the alpha is locked in insane mode. Unfortunately, that means no third person, because you guys know that I play games in third person. It's disappointing. I almost didn't do a video because of it, but I got over it. All right, what's my... Okay, it's my flashlight button. All right, so you always start in the same spot in this building, and the building is infested with NPCs, so... right, run, walk. The running... So I'm using my scroll wheel, and if you look at the bottom left of the screen, yeah, you can see that. You can see that I can set my movement speed with my scroll wheel. Another part of this game being locked on insane difficulty is that the AI's accuracy is fucking ridiculous. So you have to sneak around. This breach means kick it open, but. Okay, I think this is actually the way out. This is the way out. So I guess if you decide you don't want to be in here, you can just piss off immediately. I did take my body armor off, so if I get shot, it's probably gonna be over in one hit. So I'm trying to not get shot. breach. I don't want to... This might not be the way out. It's hard to tell sometimes what kind of things are going to be lootable and what are not. Try to find some lootable boxes and whatnot. It's a chem light. It's not radioactive. I don't really like how you stand in front of the door to open it up. I feel like that's gonna get me killed. That's pretty sure one of those is going to be lootable over there.
Batsam, get to up!
That's it. That's Escape from Tarkov. I know I hit him once, but he snapshotted and fucking blasted me immediately. So... You know, it's kind of annoying. See, it says all items I brought into the raid are found and have been lost, but I think once, oh, I missed the replay. Let's go back and see if I actually lost those items. Yeah, see, I didn't actually lose them. In fact, I didn't even lose the... I did lose the 3 rounds of ammo, so let's reload and then get another full mag and try again. It was a point blank shot with a shotgun. I don't even know if I would have survived that with body armor on. I was checking the catwalks. So every time I see one of these guys, it feels like they see me before I see them, and that's always aggravating. Like, no matter how stealthily I feel like I'm moving. And then, of course, it doesn't even matter if I see them first. As you were able to see, I still got blasted. So that does do the amping up of the suspense of playing something like this, for sure. So I was over there. I think that's the doorway that I got shot in last time. Space. Okay, yeah. I don't have a backpack or anything, so... I'm probably gonna get blasted again. This is what happened the first couple times I tried to play. I kept getting destroyed, and I finally put that body armor on. And I made it through all the way. there was a guy. So there are actually... Oh, fuck! I should have brought bandages. I did not think about that. I think I might be bleeding now. There we go. Took a headshot. Oh, that was my 15th round, too. Alright, yeah, I fucked up. I didn't bring bandages. I don't know if bleeding is a thing in this game. So that guy saw me even though I was standing completely still, hardly moving. Now I'm down to just 2 mags. Now if I could get up to him, I could get his weapon, whatever that was. You search something, you have to actually take some time to search through it. Oh, 26 mag, except it has no ammo in it, so. Alright. It does look like I'm bleeding out though, so I'm gonna die. Take any bandages with me. Search. Oh, he did have a shotgun. Take it. His hat. Dead. Oh, really? Where were those rounds going? Maybe I was just hitting him and takes more shots than I thought. Alright. I'm gonna do that one more time, but this time I'm actually gonna put some gear on before I go in. And remember to bring bandages. If I had remembered to bring bandages, I think it would have been all right. So I did get to keep that new shiny optic, but I need more 9mm ammo for my pistol. So there we go. I got a vest. Let's put some bandages in it. Where are the bandages? There we go. Whatever this thing is, first aid kit or something. Shotgun had no ammo in it, regardless. So I'll hang on to that shotgun since I've got another one. Okay. I don't know. Maybe I have to put the ammo in here to use it. Reload. I might need to buy some shotgun shells also. So let's go to the vendor and I'll see if I can get some shotgun shells and some 9mm ammo. And this time I have bandages. So I should get out again. Not wearing body armor still though. I'll see if maybe I can buy a piece of body armor. So 9x19. There are different ammo types. I don't know what all the different ammo types do. BZT, GZH. He has 133,000 rounds, though. That one's the cheapest. PSO. Oh, that's all 9x18mm. shotgun shells. Do you have shotgun shells? Did I miss them? Yeah, there we go. Buckshot, told by 70. All right, so let's buy 25 shotgun shells. And then whatever this... Oh, that's not 9 by 19. I need 9 by 19. There we go. I guess let's buy 100 rounds. Alright. Now I have to fill all my mags up. So... Reload. Can't find place for item. Why don't you... Really? Reload. There we go. And where the shotgun shells go. Uh-oh. Unload and dump this mag. Okay, so I've got 15 shotgun shells and 30 rounds of 9mm. Unload this thing too and refill it. So where's the 9mm I bought? It's right here. Refill that mag and refill that mag. Okay. Do I have a lighter body armor? No. So, I'll buy one of the lighter body armors since I have a ridiculous amount of money. So, I'm not sure how much money this actually is. I found one cash register and it had 1,000 rubles or rupees or whatever Russian currency is. And then, of course, you know, as I go through, I find guns and whatnot and you sell those to get money. Jeez. Okay. Alright, so now I've got some body armor. I've got a shotgun. I have first aid. That's the most important thing. So let's try one more time. At the factory. See if I can clear it out and escape. So I wonder if I don't click enable PvE if the factory will just be completely empty and I can loot it at my own pace. But as you can see, I put on some gear so you can see the body armor and the vest and the beanie that I looted from that AI. All right. One of the rather annoying things is it's something that Irma sort of tries to do too, but sometimes you can't get through a door sideways when you have a weapon up. As far as having, you know, hyper realism in games, that's one of the things that always annoys me because you don't, when you're playing it, a game like this, you don't really ever have a good sense of things like that, so it's annoying to be constrained by that. I know Star Citizen's doing that too. We'll see how that works out for Star Citizen. heard you can shoot lights out. There's a melee button. Isn't there a butt stroke button? I don't know. Place to go up. It's nice when they talk and give their position away. Well, I've tried nothing and I'm all out of ideas. If you guys could wander around a little bit more and expose yourselves so I can shoot you, that'd be great. And there is a button to let you turn your head independently of your direction of movement, but when you touch it, you stop moving. So it makes no sense. Why is that button even there? Why do you... I got blood on my screen, but I don't know if it's mine. Am I injured? Yeah, no, I'm not injured. So how do you search? Yeah, so he's got a vest. Thanks. So he has more shotgun rounds for me, so I'll exchange empty shotgun mag, full shotgun mag. Search pockets. Food. Nope. Alright. My blood. That's a lootable thing right there, so let's clear this corner here. I don't know how tight the shotgun patterning in this game is. I haven't tested that out yet, so I don't know. Is that lootable also? What is that? It's like a cell phone. Alright, and then a necklace. big thing I need to take advantage, full advantage of this place is, a damn backpack. Okay, those boxes over there are gonna be lootable. Alright, I don't know if I can pause this game, but I gotta pee real bad. Alright, what does he have? He has another P226. He's got a vest. Ooh, he has a backpack. Very good. So it doesn't even matter. So, until I searched the bag that I took from him... Oh, I do have a backpack. Grab a couple extra mags. We'll take those. Alright. Can I pause this? I don't think it pauses. I gotta go pee, and I can't pause the game. Yeah. She just... fairly fucking terrifying. Okay. Alright. I'm gonna have to hope that I can hide back here and go take a leak. Alright, I'm still alive. Let's get, alright. Oh, I tabbed out of game. Tab back in, that's not good. Let's tab out, tab back in again. I wonder if the glasses have anything to do with that. Well, that's not good. I tabbed out. That's really weird. So that's like the shadows for where I was looking when I tabbed out. So, save, see if that changes anything. Okay, that fixed that. Let's put him back on high. I'm surprised it only put me on high. I've got a 970. That just in time to get myself shot in the face. So you gotta move super slow. You know, you can hear the AI when they're running around and when they're yelling at each other. Yeah, see, this is an instance of where I don't like not being able to move through a doorway. Definitely hear guys talking. Over in that. But yes, it is very suspenseful. Thank you. boxes. Cheeky breeky! Are you seriously telling me that, no one from Stalker's working on this? Either one of those are. It's a 4-round magazine. I don't know what this is. I don't like that not all the boxes are lootable, or that there's no way to discern which ones are lootable and which ones aren't. I don't know how far away. How far away you can be heard. Battery. Floss. Matches. I've been playing armor so long, I expect to look in all these things and they just all be completely fucking empty. I wonder if it's a different escape every time. If it's a different series of doors you have to go through to escape. Also, I don't know how far away you can be heard from. So there's a lot of unknowns that makes movement super slow. Okay, I think this is actually the way out. Okay, yeah. So that's the way out. So if I get out from there, I get to save all this stuff. So we'll say that I've successfully completed this. Now I'm going to go and try to kill everybody and experiment around with noise levels and stuff. Or I'm going to get blasted in the face immediately by a shotgun round again. It's not gonna matter. Can you search it from the side? Nothing. Climb through here? No. Something they should add is mantling. Every game should have that. Should be standard now.
Ночевка закончилась! Подохни, ты того, как пидор! Готов нахуй!
So that guy looked like he had a Saiga with a flashlight on it, so I'm gonna have to check that. But I'll give it a moment. Make sure no one else is coming. It's not a Saiga, that's a pump shotgun. Flashlight. What did that guy have? Can't tell. Looks like maybe another pump shotgun. Search. Search buckets. Remember, those shotgun rounds are pretty freaking expensive. That one has a different colored stock. So what is this thing? Install spec. What is it? P15312H 4 end cab. It's a install. Nope, I don't know. Fuck. It's a shotgun magazine, I guess. So this vest has the same amount of storage space as the Black Rock vest, so you could technically just go into this mission if you wanted to get a little bit of gear and just, like, with nothing but a knife and just go around and kill everyone if you didn't give a shit about dying over and over again until you got decently geared up. Alright, now I'm gonna claim success, because there's nothing else I can really get, so I will extract. Okay, so that's a fairly tight pattern. That's a fairly tight pattern.
Load.
Why aren't you reloading? What the fuck? Vest in order to reload. What? All right. So I don't know why that. I don't know what kind of shotgun that is. It doesn't have a freaking front sight. And that's it. So you get a lot of XP from doing stuff like that. I wasn't trying to kill them all. I feel like if I kept pushing through there, I would have died. Alright, so now I can go back and I can unload all this stuff that I got. So I got a bunch of shotgun rounds, so... Now they only go in piles of 30. Can I reload? Nope. I got myself a new shotgun with a flashlight on it. So let's go to modding. Take the flashlight off. Oh, I see. It's got a little... Can't modify vital part with the weapon is in my hand. All right. So let's see if we can take that mod. Aha. So it's a custom pump, and it's got an extended mag. That's why it had 8 rounds. And was that an extended barrel, I guess? Looks like kind of a long barrel. 710 millimeters. Someone tell me how long that is in American. 660 millimeters. Alright, so I'll hold on to that. What else did I get? Shotgun rounds. Did I dump one of those? I think I dropped one of my Saiga mags. Bandage. Okay, so this bandage is not nearly as good as the other one. Inspect. Removes blood loss. Takes 2 seconds. This one. First aid kit containing a bunch of shit. Removes blood loss, removes pain, removes everything. Okay, so this is, I guess, a really valuable thing to have, and I've got a bunch of them. They're probably super expensive. Alright, I got a pretty cool optic, so... I'll go into the multiplayer world now, which I have not done yet. I'll take a better weapon. So I'll grab... Grab an AK with an optic on it. I haven't checked out any of the ranged optics yet. This AK is all tricked out. It's got... It's got a 3x optic, and I don't actually even know how to use the side canted red dot. And it's got a foregrip and flashlight, and is that a flashlight laser combo? Yeah, it's a light laser combo. Folding stock, but 60 round mag, so a bunch of fancy shit. So we'll dump the Saiga mags. Replace with AK mags. That gives me 120 rounds. So I'll just do that for now. Pockets. What is this? This is the flashlight that I picked up. Or that I pulled off there. So what is this optic? Inspect. Looks like that has some iron sights up on top. Oh, it's a Spectre. It's a pretty nice optic. Put that aside for later. I still don't know what the hell this thing is. MP153. Four-end cap. Oh. Okay. But it let me put 4 rounds in it. That's so weird. MP153. P1. Is that what this shotgun is? P140 MR. I know. Okay. There's a bunch of weapons, a bunch of Russian weapons in this game. Tactical Tula mount. So where does that go? Universal mount for an AK dust cover. Interesting. Get that out of there. Shotgun shells anymore. Alright, so I've got a little bit better of a weapon with a longer range. Got, oh, that magazine is not loaded. Let's make sure I have a loaded magazine before I roll out. Can you mix and match ammo types? Yes. But I still need more, so I need 5.45 ammo. Five, four, five. He's got 27,000 rounds. Let's buy. Thousand rounds. Because I have a feeling that's going to be the number one ammo type in this game. 60. Oh, Jesus. It did six. Oh, my God. That was a mistake. One of the things you can do is you can take a vest off while it has stuff in it. Put another vest on. Take that vest off. And then put the original vest on, and it still has all the stuff in it. So that, I guess that's one way you could save space in your inventory. So take this backpack. Put some stuff in it. So what is this? A suppressed Tokarev with a bunch of mags. So I can save inventory space like this. What else? None of these ammo in it. Alright. So now that backpack. I wish you could label it. Oh, you can open it. Okay, so you can easily see what's inside it. Alright. So that's a good way to save some space. But I'll stick with this for now. Should be good to go. There's no helmets, or I haven't seen a helmet in the game yet. I do have night vision, though. Where does that go? Glasses slot, helmet slot, headset slot. I don't see where that goes. Where does night vision go? Maybe it... Well, no. It's on a head mount. Ah, there we go. I'm not sure I have all my keys set up properly for that, but I guess we'll find out. I also haven't thrown a grenade yet, so I don't know how that works. Alright, so this time I'll start at customs. And I'll do online. Interesting. So it shows you who else is on the server. Oh, ammo boxes, okay. So like I said at the beginning of the stream, my main goal with this game is to play co-op. I don't enjoy the PvP aspect of games like this. But I assume everyone wants to see the PvP aspect of games like this, so we'll do it, see what happens. I don't even know how to escape this type of area. I didn't have a helmet to begin with, it was a boonie hat. matching. Okay. So this might be different. It might put me in a group with other friendlies, which would be nice. Guys, I did not have a helmet. It was a boonie hat. One of the things I did see them say in one of the videos is you are going to be able to get different uniform types and facial customizations. So you're not always going to be this one angry-looking, Neanderthal-looking motherfucker. Never done this before, so I don't know how long it takes. It'd be nice if I could go over my controls from here, because I rebound all of my controls. The main one I'm worried about is switching from the optic to the side optic. Servers are a bit iffy in this patch. I might not find a match. So what is the point of the game? Is it PvP matches? Are you trying to, like, what is the goal? What is my goal? What is my purpose in this game? What kind of beer am I drinking? I am drinking Kroger brand purified drinking water beer. I don't enjoy PvP. That's my thoughts on it. So glad Brewer's here. All right, if I don't get a match in the next minute, I'll go back into the main world on offline mode, and I'll run around for a little bit, and I'll at least check out the AK-74 and try to figure out how the optics work. Get gear, exfiltrate, get gear again. I guess that's the point of the game. I hope they... And that was a big problem with DayZ. It's sort of like, well, we got geared up, now what the fuck do we do? Like, there was nothing to do after that point. They tried to add some base building stuff in, but it never really... I don't feel like it added to the game, but I don't want to just protect my bases from a bunch of other asshole players. Like, I want something to do in the game, like a goal, like escape. This is escape from Tarkov. Like, maybe the goal should be to escape. Put together a vehicle or something. Oh. Go. Alright. I assume that's a friendly, but I don't know for sure. Guess not. So, okay. I'm glad I waited 5 minutes for that. And of course, I took my rifle from automatic fire to single shot. So when I pulled the trigger, I expected it to keep shooting. So let's see what we lost that time. Okay, we lost everything that time. So much for playing around with the rifle and the optics. But yeah, that doesn't make any sense. Why the fuck did we start back to back? So close to each other. That was my only, I guess that was my only pimped out gun like that. So let's see. Put a, no, can I not put a ranged optic on there? Can I take this off? Put a ranged optic on there. Put my hat back on. Alright, this doesn't have an offset optic, but it does have the iron sights up on top. Doesn't have any iron sights of its own though, no flip-up sights. Got a front flip-up sight. Rear flip upside. Oh, wait. I wonder if that'll actually clip through when you're trying to look through the optic. Okay, that's the same one that I looted in that last mission. Yep, same one. Modify vital parts of weapons in your hand. Pistol. Grab another 26. If I have, I'm pretty sure I have. I should have several. I thought I looted a bunch in one mission. So yeah, that I was confused, you know. When I was in that little lobby, it was like, players on this team, this people, players on this team, this people. So I figured it was going to start me with my own teammates. So I had the drop on that guy because he had his fucking back to me, but I thought it was a teammate. They started shooting me. Do we just have regular? What's this? No regular 5.56 mags. Alright, grab another grenade, another first aid kit. So, what it looked like that guy did, it looked like he had no gear on and he just had a shotgun. And he's just going in to murder players like me who have no fucking clue what they're doing and take all their stuff. Okay, do I have a smaller backpack? Purple because it has stuff in it. But, yes. I do need a backpack if I'm going to go back out. I have three of these huge-ass backpacks, so I'll just take one. Body armor. I don't want to lose another. Well, I'll just buy another one. I've got the money. body armor. Not putting night vision on again. It was the middle of the day. It's probably a nice expensive thing to have lost. All right, 45 rounds for my sidearm. I have 360 round max, so that's 180 rounds for my primary. That should be fine. Got body armor on. Put my little hat back on. Let's see if I got a pair of shades. Gotta get my eye pro. Don't see any. I didn't lose my my tomahawk though. My tactical tomahawk. Still have that. So that's good. All right, let's try again. See if I can get schwacked that quickly again. See if it takes 5 more minutes to get into another mission. Map shows the exit. One thing I did notice is I fired like what 5 or 6 rounds at that guy, and every time I fired around that recoil went way up. I would tell you what. Well, I'll show you. I don't even have to tell you. I own an AK-47, and it does not recoil like that at all. So for a game that's all about realism and having everything in it that's super hyper realistic, for me to make a shot with an AK for it to go up like that when I shoot it, when in reality it's about like this, and I can get this is literally the softest smoothest shooting gun I've ever fired in my entire life, and to see recoil like that in a game always irks the shit out of me. I already knew about the gamma container. The only reason I put it on is because you guys wouldn't shut the fuck up about it. Is there a mastery system in the game that helps you with gun handling the more you use guns? That would be nice if you start out as a... But, I mean, even then, you're supposed to be like, look at this guy. Look at this grizzled, badass, fucking veteran PMC dude that can't even handle the recoil from, like, the softest recoiling rifle in the world. So, even if there is a system like that, it's still a little bit much at the beginning. I don't know if you have skills, because I'm level 6. I don't know if that means anything. Do I get to put skill points somewhere at any point? I don't know. An AK-74. I would do range videos if I had a range that I could do videos at. Be the next Hickok 45. I don't know. You guys can go back in the video. That's the coolest thing about YouTube is even though I'm streaming, you can go back in the stream and see if I was getting shot when I was trying to shoot that guy. it's a nice modification system in this game. It might be a little too much, but I mean, if you're going to sit there and you want to dick around in your inventory forever, you can. And if you just want a bare bones M4 with some iron sights, you can just roll out with that. The thing I'm not looking forward to is having to repair weapons, because for the most part, you should be able to shoot a weapon somewhere between 5 and 25,000 rounds before you ever need to start even worrying about anything. Alright, it took about 5 minutes to get in the last match. Let's see if we get in another match. Match. I didn't know that's what the point of this game was. I thought it was more about scavenging and survival. So, from that aspect, as of right now, I'm a little bit disappointed in it. But it's still alpha, so we don't know where it's actually going to go with the survival aspects of the game. What do I do in my spare time? I do medieval armored combat in my spare time. Put on a full suit of plate armor and I beat the shit out of other grown-ass men and women. Wooden sticks. Alright. Give this one more minute. Like I said last time, if it doesn't load, I'm gonna back out and then go into the same area in offline mode. Alright. 15 seconds, then we're gonna back out. It is the SCA. That is what I do in my spare time. Fuck this. Back in. Sort of customs, but we'll go offline mode, do PvE, and go. SCA armor can be expensive. I just bought a full suit of stainless steel plate armor, which is supposed to get here later this week. And by just bought it, I mean I bought it 6 months ago. It's supposed to get here this week. But my first suit of armor was mostly barrel plastic. It cost like $300 or $400. Because I had some actual pieces of armor. Alright. Okay, there's no indicator anywhere other than actually looking as to what fire mode you're in. So that's annoying. There we go. So control right, so that's actually the same as armor. Control right click to use the different sight types. This is where I've started every time. I actually had, there's a building here that's locked and I had a key for it until I got killed. Where'd that light come from? I don't know. Oh, there's no light on this. Oh, shit. Hold up. Mod. Why can't I mod this? I want to take the, take that off. Mount. Flashlight. Fucking
Alright, is that on the right side? Yes. Okay, now I've got a flashlight. There we go.
Alright, game looks pretty good. Overall. Oops. Okay, that is one good thing about it. When you shoot, it does return your sights roughly to where they were to begin with. As opposed to Arma, when you shoot, it just goes up and up and up and stays up in the air. That's... I don't like that. So, what's that? What is it? Battery? D battery? Oh, interesting. Cigarettes. I guess those are. So you can sell this stuff. And what's that? It's food or drink. So you can search every single drawer on this thing individually. A lot of times they have keys in them. I assume you can sell all this stuff to the vendors. I don't know how wastelandish this game is. Is it like full wasteland, like sell, just scavenge and sell everything you get your hands on, or what? Green tea. Probably a bunch of worthless crap, but whatever. So you can cycle through the laser and the light on your stuff, and then you can have them both on at the same time, which it's hard to tell. It's hard to see when you have them both on. The light really diminishes your ability to see the laser, but whatever. If you have stamina, you can see the little green bar on the bottom left. It goes back up rather quickly. Well, that's neat. You can see, you can't see the laser there, but when you look down your sights, you can see the laser. That's pretty cool. What is that? Data? I can't tell what that is, because it's... Dat flakes? Pack of oat flakes. O is an O. O-8. Some of the reflections off stuff, like how that's shiny in my face. Yeah. What is that reflecting off of? That's a cardboard box. Why is the reflection off the cardboard box that ridiculous? Charging handle for an AK. It's a mag tube extension. That's the room you need a key for. Just to have. Actually, I might still have it. I think it's in one of my other backpacks. So this is the world I ran around in the first time I played, and I never ran into any AI, and I don't really know where to go. Yeah, see, Game definitely needs mantling and climbing. There's no question about that. Yeah, like, the fact that I can't get over this and into that back corner just seems really silly to me. Oh. You can do the Counter-Strike trick. You can jump and crouch. Get in there? Guess not. So yeah, game looks good. It plays pretty smoothly. I would really like to be able to go into third person, but even in offline mode, I'm stuck on hardcore mode, so I can't gauge if the third person is any good or if you can play in third person or whatnot. But I don't think I'm going to find anything, any action with some AI out here. That. Okay, so mark key. I don't know what mark is. Geiger counter, gas discharge device for automatic count of detecting ionizing particles. It is a Geiger counter. See, this is what I'm talking about. So I can't get through this doorway sideways. Like, this is never gonna happen in real life. I'm not gonna stand here in real life and be like, why can't I make it through this door sideways? You know, I'm gonna automatically lower my gun and then I'm gonna pick my gun back up when I can. So that's a problem that Arma has had a lot. It's a problem with this whole game. I guess I found the sweet spot that I could actually go through it in, but still, it's a little annoying. I think I need something that lowers. Can you do a lowered sensitivity when you're aiming down the sights? Head bobbing, profanity filter, interface layout. Ooh, interface layout. You might be able to change your stuff around. Controls, sensitivity. Ah, you can. You can lower your sensitivity while you're aiming. So let's lower it to 0.2, I guess. 2. I guess 0.21 is as close as we're going to get. All right. Still seems a little bit high to me. Let's jump it all the way down to 0.1. Yeah, I like that a little bit better. Probably not for super close range shooting. I'm sure we'll find a happy medium somewhere eventually. So where'd I go last time? There was some big ass factory I saw last time, I think way over there. I tried to go there. And I went AFK, and I came back, and I was dead. So something definitely killed me. I don't know if it was radiation or what. Okay, if there's no open option on the door, that means it's not openable. So you can kick it all day long to try and breach it, but it's not going to do anything. Let's
Let's check out the Geiger counter. Does it actually do anything? Like, can I use it? Because I don't know if I died to radiation or what at the factory. So I guess I'll make my way back over there, see if we can figure out what killed me last time. Is that my guy? Yeah. You can mutter. So I can make my guy mutter. I guess that's for getting people to come to me. Okay. I pulled out the pistol and I racked it, and I was like, that's not realistic for a realistic game. But then when I pulled it back out a second time, it didn't rack it again. Can I open this? Nice armored vehicle looking vehicle. It's weird. The sensitivity seems to go down. I'm prone, like, even more than I already have it set to. That's the kind of thing that I'm talking about. Like, that needs to be fixed. Like, there's no reason that side strafing through something like this should stop me from being able to move, because I'm trying to move left through this, and it's just like, nope. Gotta go around the other way. Could I not make it here? Maybe that's not the factory I went to last time, so I guess that's not the one I tried to go to. There's another one somewhere else. There, maybe. Oh, I don't know what this is, but check it out instead. Jacket. I don't like artificial limitations on where you can and can't go. Does this laser have a battery? So, where's the laser? So, inspect. A battery I need to worry about. Is this where I started? This is where I started. Son of a bitch. Earlier. Maybe that's where I went last time. Okay, I was not expecting that. I'm glad I was able to actually shoot that guy. So I guess there definitely are AI in here. Pistol. All right, let's see. Can I put a bag inside of a bag? Yes, good, cool. Toggle the zoom on the scope? I don't know how to toggle the zoom on the scope if that's an option. Chambers left bracket toggle under, yeah. So if I can toggle the zoom, I don't know how. It would be pretty cool. Special action modifiers, left control, change, that doesn't work, check chamber, left bracket, check ammo, P, left bracket, none of this shit's working, whatever. You actually have feet in this game. Your entire body's in the game, which is nice. Hey, Ruples! Last thing I need to do before I stop playing tonight is throw a grenade. Figure out how it works. Alright, what's over there? So I think this factory was being used as a refugee area, so there should be, or there might be some military stuff inside of it. Let's go check it out. Energy drink. So what's my... Oh, I actually do need some drinky drink. Okay, there we go. I got my drink level up. I don't even know about food. Maybe that's energy. Science, energy, electrolytes, turbo lights. Got banned for posting videos on this today. I have an email in my email saying that the NDA on Escape from Tarkov has been lifted from the Escape from Tarkov developers. What the fuck? Where were those rounds going? Serpentine! Right, where was that coming from? Yeah, I hear you. I understand you're mad at me. I also understand that it sounds like shooting a fucking shotgun and I outrange the shit out of you. Unless, of course, I can't figure out where you're shooting at me from. Slam. God damn. Alright, sensitivity's too low. Sensitivity's definitely too low. It was way hard for me to get my sights on target on that guy. Did I not heal myself all the way? Okay, I guess one use heals one limb. Alright, let's get that back up to about 0.3 maybe. So I do feel like he was shooting through the grass a little bit.
Deck, deck, deck.
I see now the sensitivity feels too high. Gotta find that. Gotta find that middle ground. He's got a Superman baseball hat. Take that. Red Son of Krypton. Unload ammo. Put that mag. Put that mag in the backpack. Oh hey, this shotgun actually has a front sight. Alright, still having trouble telling what the patterning is like. It's obviously tight enough to pop me at however far away he was shooting me from. So, okay, let's practice a little bit. Okay. Oh, wow, okay. I do not like that. I do not like that at all. So, this is like a one MOA gun. That's what, like 75, 100 meters? Those rounds are hitting in like a 3 meter radius from where I'm actually aiming. That's aggravating. Alright, 53. Around still in the mag. So that's why I wasn't hitting those guys when I thought I was shooting at them. Or shooting them. He have? Ooh, another P226. I'll take that since I lost my other one. Dump this shit. Pick this up. Can I open this? Cannot. Anything else? Pockets. space to take. Oh shit. It fucked that up. 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Shot my fucking face while I'm trying to mess with this stuff. Cool. Ooh. I will take those. Thank you. So how do I, so I have to escape, right, in order to save, in order to keep the stuff that I found. How do I do that? Okay, this is where I went AFK and died last time, or my first time I played. First time I played. Really? Can I jump over this? Seeing the refugee camp part of this factory, so I'll give it a quick run around or run through, and then I'm leaving. Now maybe I'm not allowed to go in here at all. All right. Searchable stuff over there. Oh, in PvE, if you die, you keep everything. So I can just disconnect. Alright. We'll go search this last little area, and then I'll be done. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this first extended look at Escape from Tarkov. I think it'll be a lot more entertaining with some friends. And once you're actually able to kick doors in. Shit. Can I pick it up? Drop that. I think, well, it should be able to go. Okay, so drop that. Drop that. Now, can I pick that up? Alright. Nice optic. Two nice optics. Two P226 frames. Alright, let's dump this thing. And put this here. Alright, how do I turn shit sideways? So I can put it in my inventory. Can I take the Geiger counter? Yes, apparently had enough leftover space to take that. Oh, there's a third row down there. All right. No space for my oat flakes. Put that there. Drink that. Oh, I could put that in that other slot. And then take my oat flakes back. Because they're great! So I did actually have to drink a couple times while I was going through this. I'm glad I found stuff to drink. Okay, stuff like that's not lootable. Is that another pack of smokes that I can take? What was that? I saw some option. Ooh.
Rotate items.
Alright, no one yelled at me, so I'm not gonna get murdered. Battery. Thank you, Voice of God. Or Platoon Sergeant Burr, whichever. And I'll call it here. Can I close this door? Yes. All right. Success. Raid successful. If you lead this raid, you tried to leave. Yeah, I'm leaving. So I guess that was a pretty good run. I did actually engage some AI. I didn't get any XP. It says I lost everything. But let's go double check that. Okay, I didn't lose anything. So I got to keep all the stuff that I looted. There we go. It is R to rotate items. So like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed this first look at Escape from Tarkov's alpha gameplay. It's a pretty complete game. I'll let you judge for yourself whether it's a game you want or not. That's the whole reason that you're looking at this video and watching this stream. So, if you like it, get it. If you don't like it, don't get it. I don't know what else there is to show off that I didn't look at. I showed you how to mess with the customization of the guns. I showed you the shops. I showed you... inventory management, showed you some of the PvE. I showed you one little bit of PvP, which kind of annoyed me, but get used to that as I play more. And that's about it. So like I said, I hope you... Can you really axe yourself in the leg? I don't know. I'm not going to try, though. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next video. Or stream. Or time.